I mean, it's sad. A story like this is sad. But this is the one you wanted to go with. So let's roll it out there. I didn't even know BuzzFeed had an advice columnist, but they do. His name is Steven. And a woman recently wrote in to Steven at BuzzFeed. She wanted to know what to do about her boyfriend, who says he would not propose to her unless she dropped weight. She had to lose 20 pounds before he would drop down on bended knee. They've been together for 4 years. She says things were going great until she put on 20 pounds due to an autoimmune disease that she says has ruined her metabolism, makes it hard to lose weight. This autoimmune disease. This guy's just rude. She says, and we quote, "My boyfriend lets me know that otherwise I'm his favorite person and he still finds me cute, but no longer attractive." End quote.
That's not the right couple.
She admits to being angry that he doesn't love her unconditionally, but also she says she understands that you can't choose physical attraction. Guys are physical. They like to see it.
Girls are too. I mean, yeah, there's a thing. If you're not into them, then you're not into them, you know?
He's just not that into you.
Wow.
She's been trying to lose weight, has not been successful. She wasn't sure what to do, so she turned to Steven at BuzzFeed, and he gave it to her straight.
Can you imagine if he's like, lose the weight and try to get his love?
You heard what he said.
Yeah. What's the problem?
Drop down and give me 20.
Go to Noom.
Steven agrees she should lose weight, but the weight is that fool that you're hanging out with. Get him out of your life.
Twist.
She said, or Steven says, you need to dump the guy.
You do look a little heavy.
Right. He says bodies are meant to change.
Yeah.
And even if she does lose the weight, what happens if she gains it back again? Or if she has a baby and puts on weight, how's he going to react then? Which is, they were all straight up questions.
Yeah.
What weight will be acceptable for this guy? He adds 20 pounds isn't a lot over 4 years, but he says notable weight gain would not excuse his behavior. None of this behavior is okay. In fact, it's actually borderline abusive.
Yes, of course it is.
And it's messed up. And she's accepting
it. Self-esteem. Yeah, she needs to kick him out. Find somebody new. I've definitely dated somebody that preferred skinny skinny.
Yeah.
Which I am not. I'm curvy curvy. I mean, I got some curve.
You're not. Like, I see sisters will say when they're, what do they say?
That's true.
They say they're curvy, they're overweight.
Oh, my God.
Sometimes.
Yeah, curvy's a fun way to say you're a little heavy. Well, yeah, and I wouldn't say, all right. But
brothers like curvy. Brothers like to hear curvy, and some of the white guys, too.
Yeah. But it is nice to be with someone that just doesn't comment in a negative way ever. It's such a relief. You're just like, all right, that's fine.
Who would ever? I've
been with people that have.
And I've seen people like, honey, don't eat that. You know, it makes you gain weight. I've seen guys talk to their wives like, damn, you gonna say that to her? And this is what this guy's doing. That's all he's doing.
I got headshots taken once, and the husband was photographer, and the wife was the makeup.
Oh.
It was a cool little team. Loved them. They were great. But she goes, I was in a real thin period right then. And she goes, how do you get that like this? And I said, I run a lot. And he goes, we got to get you back on the treadmill, babe.
Oh.
I know. Oh. I, this is 20 years ago, and I still think of that girl. And she went, oh, I know. Like, she was super cool with it. Like, I guess there wasn't judgment there. It was just like,
maybe they had been talking about it, and she was fine and knew that she needed to get. But damn.
And there could be a situation where a woman complains about her weight.
Yeah.
All the time. And so when a guy sees you eat, they're going to be like, please don't do that, because then I'm going to hear about it.
Yeah, but if you don't know that relationship and that dynamic, and you walk into somebody saying, please don't eat that.
Right.
Whoa.
My favorite was, I was at a diner, and I always go, no butter on the whatever I asked. And I forgot one time, and Robbie went, don't put butter on our toast. And he was helping me, but he sounded so awful and controlling.
Yeah. No butter.
You.
Margarine. So, yeah. Let's see what happens in this case. Hopefully she rolls. Roll out!